Today, I'm going to show you how to transform social media videos and presentations with one of the least understood Canva transitions. Used correctly, and you can create stunning scrolling carousels for Instagram or TikTok, help a professional audience focus on specific details of a presentation with a Zoom effect. You only need a free Canva account to get started, but if you really want to impress your audience, upgrade to Canva Pro today for a free 30-day trial so you can use all the premium Canva features such as audio tracks, the background remover tool, magic AI features, and so on. So just click the link, which I'll leave in the description box underneath the video, to get instant access. Okay, so let's make a start. The transition I'm talking about is called Match and Move. It's very similar to PowerPoint's Morph transition. The important thing to note is that Match and Move animates identical elements smoothly between pages. So let's create a beautiful scrolling carousel. So from your Canva homepage, again, I'm using the new Canva Glow Up interface, and select a vertical video template. I've got a template prepared and loaded up into my Canva design editor. Got a vertical video, I've added a little bit of text, and a photo frame. Start off with a single photo frame on your page. This is going to be the main central frame. You don't have to use this particular frame. There's a huge selection of frames to choose from. If you don't know where to find them, go to the sidebar, click Elements, go to Frames, and you'll find them here. The next step to take is to select the frame, click Duplicate, decrease the size slightly, drag it to one side. Now duplicate this frame and drag it to the other side. Make sure they're evenly spaced by selecting all the frames with your cursor. Click the three little dots, go down to space evenly, and select Tidy Up. And now I'm going to make sure that my main photo frame is in the center. Perfect. Next, you're going to create another page. It can be a blank page, and you're going to load up all the photographs that you want to use in the carousel. It just makes life a lot easier in the long run. Again, if you don't know how to upload photographs into Canva, go to the sidebar and select Uploads. Click Upload Files and upload them from your local device. I'm just going to zoom in on the thumbnail images by selecting Zoom Thumbnails and increasing the size. It just makes editing a little bit easier. Fantastic. Right, we're going to start having a little bit of fun now by adding your photographs to the photo frames. So from the second page, drag the first photograph into the first page. And you can see that it's been successful because the thumbnail image turns purple. And there it is on my first page. I'm now going to drag it into the central photo frame. Going back to the second page, select the second photograph you want to use, drag it over into the first page, and then drag and drop it into the side frame. Keep repeating this process until the first page is complete. Don't worry too much about positioning the photo within the frame. You're going to perfect it using the smart crop feature. So double click on the photograph within the frame and click smart crop. Excellent. But I think I might just pull this up just a little bit. Click done and that's it. And do the same for the other photographs. It just seems to find the right angle and set off the photograph perfectly. The next step is to duplicate the first page. So select the thumbnail image in the video timeline with your cursor. Now click on the three little dots or right click to open up a small editing menu. Now click on Duplicate Page. The carousel is going to scroll from right to left. So on the second page, select the main photograph, click on the three dots, select Detach Image, and you're going to drag the photograph into the left-hand photo frame. The photo on the far right now becomes the main photograph. So select the photo frame with your cursor, click the three dots, select Detach Image and drag the photograph into the main frame. You now need to drag and drop a new photograph from your collection into the photo frame on the right, which is now blank. And that's it. Repeat this step as many times as you need. I would suggest 6 to 8 pages would be sufficient. If you run out of photographs, don't worry, you can just start from the beginning again. Once you've completed all the pages in your carousel, you're now ready to add those magical finishing touches. To transition each page smoothly from one to the next, hover your mouse between the first and the second page and you'll see this little tiny icon which says Add Transition. So click that and that will bring up a menu of transitions on the right-hand side of your screen. If you're still using the old interface, you'll find the menu on the left-hand side of your screen. The transition you're going to select is Match and Move. And you can already see, as I hover my cursor over the thumbnail, the effect it has on your template. Adjust the duration, if you want, by holding your cursor over this button here and dragging it along the slider bar to the right to increase the duration and to the left to decrease it. Generally, I just stick with 0.5 seconds because that really is sufficient. Right at the bottom of the transition menu, you'll find a button that says Apply Between All Pages. And I'm going to click on that to save myself having to repeat this step for each new page. And that's done. And if you look at the video timeline, you'll see the little transition icon between each page. If you're going to be sharing your template on social media, you'll need to adjust the duration of each page in your template. So select the first page in your template. A floating menu of editing options will appear right at the top. You're going to click on the clock icon to edit the timing of this page. And I usually set the timing between 2 and 3 seconds. You can either select the little button and slide it along the slider bar to increase the timing, or to be very precise, place your cursor in the timing box and then type the duration that you want. If you want to apply the same timing to each page, save yourself a lot of time by toggling this little button to the on position to apply to all pages. And that is pretty much it. To add some finishing touches for that extra wow factor, consider animating the text, add some graphics or animated stickers, or even add an audio track from the Canva library. So I'm going to play this back now to see what it looks like. You can find out more about Canva transitions, how to add them to a template and even customize them in this video, which is coming up next. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel for more content just like this. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you next time.